My name is Martin Steinhoff. I am the professorial chair for the Department of Dermatology here at UCD, as well as the director for the Charles Institute for Translational Dermatology. And today we will talk about a significant problem in dermatology, namely itch or pruritus, which is the number one symptom in dermatology. And millions of patients suffer worldwide because of chronic itch. And the significant problem is that we don't have sufficient medications to help those patients long term. We know that antihistamines are only working in less than 50% of the cases to suppress itch. So there are mainly more than 60% of the patients who still suffer from itch, even if they take medications. And that is what we are studying and what we try to stop. We hypothesize that beside histamine, there must be also other neuromediators which are important. And itch and others also have shown already that endothelin is a very potent itch mediator in animals, but their role in the mechanism and also their role in humans have not been studied so far, and therefore we ask the question whether endothelin is a potent itch mediator in humans and whether this control of endothelin mediated itch is important in humans and can be also blocked by using certain inhibitors. So first of all, we identified endothelin colocalizing with its receptor on neurons and also colocalizing with a peptidase defined as endothelin converting enzyme 1, EAS1. And this enzyme seems to be important for the regulation of endothelin in neurons. When endothelin binds to its receptor on sensory nerve, then normally the complex internalizes. And EAS1 regulates the trafficking of the receptor back to the cell surface, thereby inhibiting endothelin-induced cell signaling. Now, if you use an inhibitor of EAS1, then you can prolong the cell signaling of the receptor in the cell, and this leads to activation of a cell signaling cascade, which then leads to itch transmission. Itch transmission can be prolonged if we stimulate EAS1 or activate EAS1, and vice versa can be inhibited if we block this pathway. And that has therapeutic consequences, because if we show that this is not only important in mice but also in humans, then we can use certain blockers, for example, endothelin receptor blockers, or activate or stimulate EAS1 and thereby suppressing the itch process. And this is important because we have so many patients which still suffer from itch, even if they take the medications which we have nowadays, because we haven't understood so far many of these processes. And with understanding this process, at least we can hopefully help a part of these patients who suffer severely from chronic itch.